feel it's very important to make the fashion industry more sustainable. It's the second polluting industry in the world. But the solar technology is developing and is becoming more thin and flexible. This really gives new opportunities for fashion. I'm a fashion designer working in the field of wearable technology, implementing new technologies to make our garments respond in a different way and therefore also communicate in a different way. Wearable technology is able to connect different industries that were not connected before. I'm being connected with people from the solar energy industry, and we look at what we can mean for each other to advance our idea of what fashion is or could be in the future. Well,
hi there, good afternoon. My name is Pauline van Dongen. I'm a fashion designer specialized in wearable technology. But most of all, I'm a curious person. My inquisitive nature often drives me towards things that I don't know or do not master in terms of skills. A big part of my work evolves around creating something that is new. It's about adapting knowledge and processes from outside my design practice and looking at how fashion can benefit from it. So let me ask you, how many of you were already familiar with the term wearable technology? Please raise your hand. Wow, this is really good. Great. And how many of you already own a piece of wearable technology? Okay, this could be a little bit better. So today I'd like to show you some examples of my work to give you an insight in how wearable technology will develop in the near future, and especially what it can mean to all of us. Technology is often seen as something harsh and metallic, but I aim to make it soft by naturalizing it and bringing it close to the body. Nowadays, we see a lot of garments where technology has been put on, but I believe that ultimately the technology should become invisible, working from the inside out. So by experimenting with new materials and technologies, I constantly try to innovate traditional craftsmanship. An example of my approach is this shoe design that I developed in 2010. It became the first fully 3D printed shoe design in the world. I'm very interested in the concept of liquid modernity, which was introduced by the sociologist Sigmund Bauman. It describes the idea that our contemporary surroundings are constantly changing, and they have become liquid under the influence of technology. So for me, the future of fashion lies in its premise to be dynamic, adaptive, and responsive, just like these fluid surroundings. So for one of my recent collections, I developed a dynamic textile that would enhance the interaction between the body and the garment. I used a neoprene that I laser engraved into this resilient line pattern, and these lines would change their expression along with the body's movement. To illustrate the idea of liquid modernity, I'd like to show you a project that I did back in 2012. It's called the flip dot dress. It's made up out of tiny flip dots, which are electromagnetic discs that can flip from one side to the other. And this kinetic garment can respond to the surroundings in terms of sound. And not only did I want to mount 600 of these on a garment, I also wanted to address each dot individually so that the garment could actually function as a display. So I quite naively put myself to the task to create this wiring diagram, which became quite a challenging puzzle, especially because I had limited experience with creating electrical circuits. But I had a partner in crime, Daniel Schatzmeier, who's an electrical engineer and robot hacker. And together with him and also a few fashion as well as engineer students, we made over 4,500 soldering connections. And you have to believe me, this is a very organized chaos. We also developed a custom-made PCB so that we could wirelessly communicate with the dress. So after a while on the inside, when we hooked it up, it looked like this. The PCB is placed right at the back in between the shoulders. And the amazing thing was that we were able to complete the full design in only 1 month time. To me, the fascinating thing about technology is that it constantly gives us new choices, new possibilities. To me, it's not only a tool, but even more so, an aesthetic. My recent project, Wearable Solar, shows the importance of creating something that is desirable. Because in the end, people should actually like to wear it. Our society highly depends on connectivity. I bet that most of you are addicted to their smartphones, just like me, and we want them to be constantly powered. But the better our batteries get, the more we'll use them. There are two things we always have with us when we leave the house: our clothing, at least I hope we're all dressed, and our phone. So why not power your phone through your clothes? Wearable solar gives you the opportunity to charge your phone on the go wherever you are. For this project, I collaborated with a business developer and a solar energy expert. And we started out looking at various solar cells that were available in the market. We looked at their efficiency, the way that they could be integrated, because you can't simply sew them, you would immediately short-circuit them. And I started looking also at the way these solar cells are built. So for the design concept, I looked at this layer buildup and this interaction of all these layers with the sunlight. And I immediately started comparing this with the stratification of the human skin. And this idea I then translated into a modular design that comprises of parts with solar cells that can be revealed when the sun shines, or folded away and worn invisibly when they're not directly needed. And each of them, when worn in full sun for only 2 hours, will charge your phone from 0 to 100%. These designs are still prototypes, because the cells that were used were not specifically made for textile. One of the main issues, for instance, is that they're not washable. So we're now looking at solar harvesting fibers, printable solar cells, and washable textile circuits to upgrade the design. And I've placed these two striking designs in the high fashion market, but the concept has a wide range of applications. You can think of casual wear, sportswear, military gear, or even sails of tents of boats. And today I have a small premiere for you, because I brought with me one of the designs that we just made. It incorporates the world's most efficient flexible solar panel, and it's actually integrated in such a way that you can separate it from the garment in case of cleaning. So our model Constance is now pairing up her phone, plugging it to the micro USB, and she can immediately start charging, even with the light here inside. We don't necessarily always need the sun. Thank you very much. I wasn't done yet. Ultimately, we can use the generated energy for other interactive qualities, like powering the light in this jacket that I've designed for Philips. So, as you've seen today, I'm often trying to unite two seemingly divergent industries. Working in wearable tech requires a new way of thinking about garment construction, manufacturing, life cycles, but also washing and repairing. And these are some of the things that I'm currently researching as part of my PhD program called Crafting Wearables at the University of Technology in Eindhoven. But probably the best thing that I can share with you today is that there's no secret recipe for making the impossible. From my point of view, it's all about collaboration. It's the network and the exchange of knowledge and experience that really matters. Often we are unaware of what new developments might mean to us. Like, for instance, when we were first introduced to the computer or the mobile phone, nobody knew what to do with it. We didn't need them, but now, yes, we do. So today, I hope that I gave you a little bit better understanding of what the future of fashion beholds for all of us. And please keep in mind that we're only just at the start of it. Thank you very much.